Good morning, students. My name is Poonam Daswani. I hope you all are good and your family is doing great. Students, today we will continue with the computer lesson number 3, Tux Paint. Computer lesson number 3, Tux Paint. In the previous lecture, we only studied what is Tux Paint and how it is open. So today we will be moving ahead with the chapter. So let's have a quick look on the previous points, what we studied in the previous lecture. Tux Paint. What is a Tux Paint? Tux Paint is a wonderful drawing program for children. Unlike other drawing painting programs, Tux Paint has a lot of creative tools. Funny animations and magical effects, which make it one of the best drawing software. What is it? It is a best drawing software. Tux Paint is a drawing software. When you open a Tux Paint, this is the Tux Paint. You have many features in it. Features of Tux Paint. What are the features of the Tux Paint? Tux Paint is a free software. Tux Paint has a drawing mascot who helps you to know more about Tux Paint. A large variety of tools help the children to bring out their best creative designs. We can add personalized stamps on our drawing once we finish it. Funny sound effects are played when we select any tool. We can load and save images directly as thumbnails, and there is no need to specify a file name. Now, Tux Paint has a free software. It is a free software. If you want, you can download it in your computer. Tux Paint has a drawing mascot. It is a which has many features. Who helps you know more about Tux Paint? It has many features so that if you want to draw many designs, you can draw it. But in the MS Paint, it is not that. It is limited. There are no graphic designs. There are no added pictures in the MS Paint. As we saw in the video also, in the previous video, that Tux Paint has more options than MS Paint. A large variety of tools help the children to bring out their best creative designs. As the tools have a large variety, there are many images already saved in the Tux Paint. So if you want, you can the children can draw many designs, creative designs. You can choose many creative designs. You can also add the images from the Tux Paint, and you can also draw your own designs. We can add personalized stamps. We'll see what are the personalized stamps in the Tux Paint. After you finish drawing, you can also add personalized stamps that we will see ahead in the chapter. Funny sound effects. When you select any option, sound effect is given to every button when you click on it. So it makes it more interesting for children to do the drawing. And you can upload and save images directly. You don't need to save the file and name it. It gets saved directly as thumbnails. Now we move ahead. How to open a Tux Paint? What you have to do to open a Tux Paint, you have to on the computer. Then you have to click on a start button. Then after clicking on the start button, you have to choose all programs. Then the third thing what you will do, you will click on the Tux Paint. When you click on all programs, you get many programs in it, many files and many windows in it. When you click on it, you get a Tux Paint. You click on a Tux Paint, then you have to choose windowed. Tux Paint windowed, so that you can draw your drawing on it. When you click on the Tux Paint window, this is the welcome screen of the Tux Paint. You get it on your computer screen on the monitor. After the welcome screen, you will see the opening screen of the TuxPaint. When you open the, this is the welcome screen, and now you see the first window, first screen of the TuxPaint, which has tools, toolbox, which has sub toolbox, which has brushes in it, and there is a color palette in it. So in toolbox you have many options. In brushes you have many options to draw the design in thick or thin you want, whichever size you want you can draw, and you can choose many colors in it and you can draw your painting and color it. Fact file: the lead developer and designer of TuxPaint is Bill Kendrick. He is the main designer of the TuxPaint. Let us know more. TuxPaint is an awarded winning free software for children with many interesting features. It has many interesting features. It is awarded and it is a free software for children. You can download it from the www.tuxpaint.org. Let's discuss TuxPaint versus MS Paint. Now there are differences between TuxPaint and MS Paint. What are those differences? We will see. The difference between TuxPaint and MS Paint are as follows. The TuxPaint is a painting software for kids, whereas the MS Paint or Microsoft Paint is a tool of Microsoft Windows. It is a software for kids, and MS Paint is a tool in the Microsoft Windows. It is already there in the Microsoft Windows. It is a tool of Windows, and TuxPaint is a software. You have to download it, and it is a tool of Microsoft, means it is already there in the Windows. The TuxPaint is a graphic editor, whereas the MS Paint is used to draw, edit and color pictures. Graphic editor means you can add many graphics, like when you write in the letters, you can write it in many shapes and designs. You can give it a graphic background and many things, and you can also draw the pictures which are already there in the TuxPaint. You can add many pictures which is there, but in MS Paint you don't have the graphic editor, you don't have the pictures in it, ready-made pictures. It is only used to draw and color the pictures and edit the pictures. But in TuxPaint there are many pictures already there, as we saw in the previous lecture in the video. TuxPaint is required to be purchased for installation in the computer, whereas MS Paint comes installed in the Microsoft Windows. Now, as it is a software, you need to download it in your computer. If you want TuxPaint, you need to download it. And MS Paint is already there in the computer. When you purchase it, MS Paint is already present in the computer, but TuxPaint is a software, so you need to download it. Now we move ahead. This is the this is the welcome screen of the TuxPaint. When you open a TuxPaint, you get a screen like this. There are tools, there are brushes, and there are colors, color palette. When you open MS Paint, you get the screen of the MS Paint in this manner. So you can see there are no options for MS Paint, but there are many options in the TuxPaint. Now we move ahead with the paint tool. Paint tool. What is a paint tool? Whenever we start TuxPaint, the paint tool is selected by default. Means whenever you open TuxPaint, as you see in the welcome screen, when you open a TuxPaint, paint tool is already there. When you can see in the blue color paint, it is already there. As you can see in the image, blue color paint. When you open a TuxPaint, paint is by default in the TuxPaint. It is there. You don't need to open it separately. It gets opened on its own when you open a TuxPaint. It is used to paint and draw anything that you like. It is used to paint and draw anything that you like. It is similar to the brush tool. It is similar to the brush tool in MS Paint. We can use it to draw freehand images or sketches, as well as select various brush shapes present in subtool box. It is similar to the MS Paint because both are used for painting. You can draw freehand images or sketches using various brush present in the subtool box. Let us start drawing a scenery using the paint tool. What is a paint tool? Paint tool is there in the tools. Bring the mouse pointer to the drawing area. As you can see, bring the mouse pointer to the drawing area. The shape of pointer changes from hand to a brush. When you bring the mouse pointer on the Tux Paint, it changes from finger hand to a brush. Select the brown color from colors palette. Draw a few mountains at the upper part of the drawing canvas. Now choose yellow color and draw a small sun, the mountains as shown in the figure. You can draw this image also, as you can see, using the paint tool. You can select paint, then mouse pointer will change from hand to the brush, and you can select brown color. You can draw mountains, then you can select yellow color and you can draw the sun. Students, I would like to show you a video how a paint tool is operated. It will become more easy for you to use a paint tool when you see the video. So here is the video.
Hello children, welcome to my channel. Today we are going to learn a wonderful software that is Tux Paint. It is an award-winning free software for children with many interesting features for drawing and coloring. So let's start then. So let's have a quick glimpse on the screen. This is your Tux Paint. This is your working area or drawing area. These are your tools. By default, always the paint tool is selected. These are the colors and these are the brushes. How to open the Tux? You have to just click on Start, All Programs, Tux, and Tux Paint Windowed. This is a windowed version of Tux Paint. So now let's start with the paint tool. Children, you have learned the pencil tool in MS Paint, right? The same way paint tool works. Paint tool, you will see this different kind of brushes. You can select any of brushes and you can draw in any picture. See, this is the thin brush. Now I select the thick brush. You can see the changes in the brush. Thickest brush. So this is about your paint tool. You can erase this drawing by using eraser tool. This is the eraser tool. You have to select the eraser tool from this. Then you can change the shape of your erasers like this from here. Erase your drawing. That's it. Your drawing will get erased. Next is haze brush tool. You can see this deactivated brush tools, right? This 1, 2, 3, 4. These are the haze brush tools. It gives hazy appearance to is giving a hazy appearance to the picture. That's why it is called as haze brush. This is all about haze brush tools. Next, coming to the magic tool. Before showing magic tool, where is this? So it's a time for the magic. You have to select magic tool. Under the magic tool, in this subtool box, there are lots of magic tools are there. You can select any to check. So let's take first patterns. So you have to just select this pattern. See, wow, isn't it a magic? Yes, Now let's see one more magic tool. Wow. Let's see one. These are foam effect, I think. See? Wow. So this is all about magic tool. In magic tool, we will see the bricks magic also. You can see these two bricks tools. For that, first I have placed this. So we'll learn about this bricks magic. For that, I have to draw one house. So I'll select these lines. I'll select a thick line. I'll draw one house. I'm using line tool. Okay. Oops. From shapes, I'll select the circle. Draw one circle. Yes, there are so many shapes are there under the shape tools. You can select any. These are the fields shapes. And these are the unfilled shapes. So now let's go for the magic tool. In magic tool, select the field tool. Children, this field tool is used to fill color in the particular picture. You have to just select the field tool, then select any color and just click on the desired area you want to fill the color. And now we'll go to the bricks. So these are your bricks. Select the brick. There are two bricks. You can select any brick design and go. Bricks are getting applied automatically. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, like that. I'm clicking continuously. About your bricks magic. My house is ready. Wow. Now I'll just erase it to show you the tool. Now we'll see the grass magic. The grass magic applies the grass effect in the picture. So let's draw some flowers. Oops, I have to select black. Using paint tool here. My flower is ready. Now I'll apply some color using magic tool. Then I'll select field tool, select color. Or any color you can select. It's your choice. Select green color. Now I'll select the grass effect from the magic tool sub tool box. So this is your grass. I have already selected the green color. Now click on the drawing area. See. Automatically the grass is getting applied. But you can just select continuously. See. Wow. Pretty. So this is your grass effect of the magic tool. Now we will learn about the blur magic. The blur magic is also there in the magic tool sub toolbox. So you can see the blur effect. This is your blur tool from the sub toolbox. As you apply the blur on the picture, you can see the picture is getting blurred. See. As many times as you select it, the picture will get more blurred. See. You can see the grass is changing in blur effect. Again, I'll select. Yes. So this is all about blur magic. It makes your picture blur or light. Now I'll erase this drawing again. Now we'll learn flower magic. For Flower Magic, you have to select Magic Tool, then click on this arrow and select the Flower Tool. So this is your Flower Tool. What it does, it directly, once you click on the drawing area, the flower will get applied to your drawing area. You have to just select the Flower Tool, then select the color and just go on clicking. See, the ready-made flower will get applied to your drawing area like this. Isn't it a beautiful tool? So this is all about your flower tool. Now, where is it? And next coming to stamp tool. Stamp are the ready-made pictures or stamps which are available in the Tux. You can see here the stamps. You can download it from the tux.org, or here ready-made some stamps are there. You can decide this. Here, this is the small size, this is the biggest size, and just select the stamp and click here. Automatically the picture will get applied. The picture will get inserted. Yeah, change the size, the stamp will get changed. See, this is the first one. So like this, the automatically the ready-made pictures will get inserted by using the stamp tool. Now erase it again. Next is text tool. The same like the text tool of the MS Paint. You have to just drag it here. But instead of the dotted rectangular box which appears in the MS Paint, here directly one blinking cursor will get appear. You can just start typing. Wow, welcome to Rashmi's Learning Planet. So this is all about your text tool. And you can change the font size from this letters box, you can see. So this is all about the text tool. That's it. Now, how to save the Tux Paint? Tux Paint provides an easy method to save the work. You have to just click on Once you click on save option, they will ask you two options. Yes, replace the old one. No, save a new file. Click on no, save a new file, and without entering any name to the file, automatically a thumbnail will get saved. That's it for today. Thank you for visiting. Thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe my channel to if you want to see some.
So students, we saw in the video how to use the paint tool and how to use the different effects of the paint tool and the Tux Paint to make our drawing interesting and beautiful. Now we move ahead. As you saw on the video, it made easy for us to understand how the paint tool is used. Now we move ahead. Select blue color and draw a wavy line forever as shown in the figure. Now you know how to draw images in the paint tool in Tux Paint. So you know what you have to click on and how you can draw the images. So you have to first click on the paint, and then in the subtools there are options for thick and thin lines which you can draw, or you can select the image from the subtool box also. Now we move ahead to the subtool box. The subtool box is a unique feature of Tux Paint. which you can see in the right side. For every tool in Tux Paint, we have many options of brushes, shapes, special effects in the sub tool box. As we saw in the video, when we click on the paint, you get many options of paint. When you click on the shape, you get many options of shapes. When you click on the text, you get many options of text. When you click on the brush, magic brush, you get many options in that. So subtool box is a unique feature that have many options like brush, special effect, graphic effect, many effects it has in the toolbox. We can choose any brush shapes from subtool box on the right hand side. We have more than 50 different shapes, but only few are used. Let us select different brush shapes and learn how to use them. There are more than 50 different shapes, but children use only a few of them. Like we will see which are the common brush shapes that we use. Haze brush. As we saw in the image, saw in the video, how the haze brush is used. So we will read and we'll come to know more about it. Haze brush is a unique sub tool which has a hazy appearance. As we saw in the video, when we click on the haze, we get a hazy appearance, means a little bit lighter and darker image. We can use it to draw objects that are far away. As you can see, the far away images are a little bit lighter. So you can use haze brush to draw the image. Select the paint tool. Now select the haze brush shape and select light blue color. Draw a few clouds in the sky. As you see, you see the clouds, and outside lining images lining you see in the when you look at the clouds. So that is the hazy effect of the cloud, which you can give in your Tux Paint image also, but this option there is not there in the MS Paint. Similarly, select green color and draw the trees as shown in the figure. As you can see, if you're going on a road and the mountains are far, you can also see the trees which are far away. So you get a hazy look of the trees also. So you can give a hazy look to whatever which you want. Great, we have learned how to use haze brush shape. Time for some magic. As we saw in the video, there is also a magic tool which you can use to give magic effect to the picture. The most special feature of Tux Paint is the magic tool. We can use the magic tool to draw and give amazing effects to a picture. As we saw in the picture, we can give amazing effects, like you can give many effects. Select the magic tool. The pointer will change to magic wand. As you can see, the hand of the mouse pointer will change to a magic wand, that is like a magic stick. Now we will apply some magical effects to our drawing. Drawing a river. Now if you have to give a, this is the haze brush effect. Now time for some magic. You can give bricks magic effect. Select the bricks tool, bricks sub tool. The bricks effect fills bricks into the picture. Draw a hut using the lines tool and apply bricks effect. You can give magic effect through the bricks effect, as we saw in the video also. Let us see what happens to a hut when we use the bricks effect. Now you are drawing a plain hut, and when you give a brick effect, your hut appears like this, as you can see in the image. Now in this picture you have drawn using the paint magic with the brushes. You gave the haze effect, which are the things far away. You can see it is in a hazy look. There is a magic effect also in the image, which you gave to the hut. That is the bricks effect. You can select any color to give the your choice of your color. Now we move ahead to the blur magic. Blur, as we saw in the video, what is the blur magic? You can give blur effect also. The swap tool blurs the area of the picture on which it is applied. Let us see how it works. This subtool blurs the area of the picture on which this effect is applied. Let us see how it works. Select the magic tool and then the blur effect from the subtool. As we saw in the video, first select the magic tool, then select the blur effect from the sub toolbar, which is on the right side. Apply it all over the boundary of the mountains, and how it looks, you can see the blur effect as many times as you like. Now you can see in the image blur magic. First you have to select the magic in the tools. Then you will select the blur in the sub tool, which is right side. Tools is in the left side, sub tool is in the right side. Now you will give a blur effect to the mountains. You can see a blur picture. You can see the blur picture, as we also saw in the video, to give the blur effect. Blur effect means which we cannot see clear, it is a little bit blur. Using grass effect. Now we will move on to using a grass effect. It is used to give grass effect in a drawing. Now first we started with the line tool, brush tool, line tool, haze effect, brick effect, that is in the magic effect. Then we went to the blur effect. Now we are going to the grass effect. It is used to give grass effect in a drawing. Click on magic tool. First, what you have to do, you have to click on the magic tool and select the grass effect from the sub tool box. As we see, there are many options in the sub tool box. We have to use the grass effect from sub tool box. Select green color from the colors palette. As the grass is the green color, you have to choose green color from the color palette. Now draw some grass by clicking on the canvas as shown in the figure. What is the canvas? That is the blank area where you can draw on the computer or your laptop. Using fill tool, as you saw in the video, how to fill the color using a fill tool, we will see in the textbook now. It is used to fill color in an object. The magic tool is already selected. Select fill tool and choose blue color from the colors palette. Students, I would like to tell you that if you are not understanding when you are reading the chapter, I would want you all to go to the video again and again and see the video, so that it becomes easy for you to know how the Tux Paint is used. Using fill tool effect, it is used to fill color in an object. The magic tool is already selected. Select fill tool and choose blue color from the color palette. Now bring the magic wand over the river and click on it. The blue color will be filled in the river. Select brown color and click on the mountains to fill brown color in them. When you click on the object and you select the fill tool, you can fill the colors in your picture. This is the grass effect using the fill tool. This is the way you can give colors effect to the fill tool. Likewise, fill yellow color in the sun and red color in the roof of hut. Yellow color for sun and red color for roof of the hut. So in this way you can draw your pictures. You can also see the darker grass in the image and the trees which are dark green in color. That was the haze effect, and you gave the blur effect to the grass, magic effect. So you can give any effect to the picture you want, which you draw the design. Now we move on to using flower tool. Now you want flowers in your picture. So you will use flower tool. It is already, it is a ready-made option to draw flowers on the canvas. As you saw in the video, when you click on the flower option, you get the option of flowers. Click on the flower tool, which is a sub-tool of magic tool. Flower is in the magic tool. Select red color from the canvas, from the colors palette. Bring the magic wand over the grass. Keep clicking on the grass area to add flowers on it. Likewise, select different colors to add colorful flowers on the grass, as you can see in the image also. Using flower tool in this way you can put different color flowers like red, orange, pink. You also saw in the video how to draw the flowers in the Tux Paint. Now we move ahead to the stamp tool. This is the unique feature of the Tux Paint. This is the stamp tool. It is a simple tool which is used to put a stamp and add images in your drawing. Now if you have to add images in your drawing, you can add from the stamp tool. Tux Paint already has some inbuilt stamps, means which are already put in the Tux Paint. Additional stamps can be downloaded from the following website. You can download other images. If you don't want the images there are already in the Tux Paint, you can download from www.tuxpaint.org/download/windows. So if you click on this website, you will be able to see the different images which can be used as a stamp tool to add pictures in your painting, in the drawing. Further select link Tux Paint -stamp-2009.6.28-win32-installer.exe. On installing the stamps file, we can see various categories of stamps in the subtool box. If you download this, you can also see the various categories, various different images which you want in your Tux Paint. Click on stamp tool. Stamp tool is there in the toolbox. When you click on the stamp tool, you get different images in the right side of the Tux Paint, that is the sub tool. Choose any one stamp from the sub toolbox. For more stamps, click on right or left arrow. Select the cock stamp. Suppose if you have to select a cock stamp, So you will click on the cog and then it will be appeared in your window. You can also increase or decrease the size of the stamp using slope bar. As you saw in the video, by using the slope bar you can increase and decrease the size of the stamp tool. Just above the colors palette in the sub toolbox, it is in the right side, as you can see in the image. As you can see here, it is above the color palette in blue color here, and the left and the right arrow gives you the option to choose the different images. As you can see in the image, you can put stamps in your image to give the more effective drawing. You can also click on the mirror option to get mirror image of your stamp. Suppose you want two images on the opposite side, so you can click the mirror image which is below the two arrows in the sub toolbox, and you can get the images on the opposite sides, one in this face facing this side and one facing left side, one facing right side. If you click on the mirror option, you get mirror image of your stamp image. Adjust the size of your stamp image using slope bar, as you can increase or decrease the size of the stamp image. Students, here we stop with the lecture. The remaining part of the chapter we will do it in the next lecture. I hope you all understood the chapter. If you have any doubts or queries, you can mail it to me. If you want to know more about the tux paint, practice it at your home if you have a laptop or your PC. And if you don't have, go through the video and see the video how the options are used to draw the tux paint. So it will be easy for you to understand the chapter. Go through the video and you can know how to use the tux paint. Thank you students for listening to the lecture. Thank you so much.